So I think that there's a couple of success stories that we need to talk about. And first, the first one is very significant, and that's your successful fire mitigation and suppression program this season. After the closure by the FRA and the Rio Grande National and Carson National Forest Service in 2002, this past year, both communities were extremely nervous because those of us that lived through it, and there are several of us sitting here, it was scary. And I think everybody was very on edge and very, very concerned that that was going to happen again. So the fact that you got through the season with Durango shut down and everything that happened there, that's a success story. The other success, one of the other success stories in Chama particularly, has been the Northern New Mexico Welcome Center. Governor Martinez cut the Department of Tourism budget by 5%, and so there were two of the visitor centers in the state, or actually there were four of the eight that were shut down, and Chama was one of them. And through a collaborative effort between Mayor Elbrock, the Chamber of Commerce, the Railroad, Rio Riba County, we were able to reopen it and have the Chamber run it. The Railroad has a very significant presence in the visitor center. I don't know how many of you have been in there, but the display that was in the Coombers Mall that I think belongs to the Friends is now located there, and the Friends this year provided docents that helped out. So the contribution has not only been monetary, but it's been in manpower and physical assets that we've been able to place in the visitor center and really bring attention to the railroad. The visitor center is the single largest distributor of brochures in the local area. The amount of brochures that go out of that visitor center is almost mind-boggling at times. So not only is it a success in the community, but I've had several comments from legislators and people within the Department of Tourism, and especially ex-Department of Tourism Secretary Latham. She said, this is a perfect example of how a public-private enterprise can work and keep up the good work. So I hope that we continue to be a very significant force in the Welcome Center as it goes on. There's little success stories that you probably don't hear about, but I do. And one of them that I want to bring to your attention is the Chama Chili Ski Classic, for example. It's a Chama planned event, but it takes place in Colorado. So that state line kind of disappears. This year, somebody, I'm not sure who it was, decided to enter Cinder in the snowshoe contest, the snowshoe race. And the positive feedback that I've gotten back from that single event has been rather amazing. Number one, the fact that they got that bear in the costume and in snowshoes, and she could actually walk in it, is amazing. But those are the kinds of things, you know, we can't just be a railroad. We have to be good community members. And these types of success stories, I think, are sort of where, Dan, you possibly are directing us to head on this side of the hill. So if we can find a venue, whether it's the Alamosa Chamber of Commerce or someplace where we can really embed ourselves in the community in a positive way, I think that's a good goal for us.
What's your sense, Kim, of speaking of pot, the possibility of New Mexico adopting a similar stance towards pot to the one that Colorado has chosen to follow? I ask that question because it's obvious to me anyway that if you look around Antonito, if New Mexico offered access to legalized pot, a lot of the revenue that has been attracting this new industry in Antonito will perhaps dry up. And so that's a double whammy in my view. Where does all this play out in terms of our relationship with one of our two star towns?
So one of the things that has happened since May is, and I think this was an anticipation of a new governor and the lack of commitment from the legislators to fund both the commission and capital outlay requests for the past 8 years, I was asked to kind of step up and become more involved in the legislative process. So through that, I've spent 7 of the last 8 days last week in Santa Fe, either testifying or listening to testimony or waiting to testify or visiting senators and representatives. So what I have come away with from that is that New Mexico this year, as the legislative process continues, they are not going to legalize marijuana.